Yeah, but it's, if you look out there, there's a big field over there. Take some squash, beer or whatever, a bit of pot or whatever, isn't it? Yeah. Isn't it? Barley or whatever, that's all they do around here.
They fix that bump. This is the entrance in and out of the flats, really. Can't get round the other way.
Well, your Ketton Beach is longer, isn't it?
Yeah, but if you've got a car.
No.
It's like there's horses in the field out the back, but like people don't like it because it's private land and it's their horses. They don't like you going in the field.
No.
The first day our car got, the window got smashed. The second day it got smashed bigger. And the third day it was burnt down, the whole car. My dad called the police about it and he wanted to, he was mesmerized by what happened and he wanted to make a change in Tilbury. And I think slowly that grew.
This is the park, they like much of a park though. There's one bench where you can sit down.
That's the only seating area in the park, that one bench.
That little bench there. Got swings and little sand things that you can't even hang off. Look, there ain't even handles on them. There's not even handles on them, Chels.
Hello? Yeah. Alright. Yeah. Yeah, I've got a couple of little boys with me now because I'm looking after them. Yeah, I will do. Alright, bye.
That's my Chevy.
Yeah? I don't know. No. My little Rouge boy, Ben.
Went to the package shop to buy some wine.
We only do it up because Tilbury's boring. It's not worth it. Right, especially if we're here. Tilbury's got nothing to do.
We can do the best.
So all we can do is either put the boxing gloves on and bite each other sick again. Or tomorrow we're meant to be going swimming though. So if you can get the money, we'll all go swimming. Oh. Like there is quite a few of us going. I'll help you swim. I always help people
swim.
Yeah.
It's £2.
But it gets out of Tilbury for a little while.
She lives on a swelp, she lives on 11, but I live on a 10. So like we all help each other out. We all know when each other gets paid, we help each other out till paydays, things like that. Because it is hard living on benefits. It is hard.
You can't have a job because he was going to look after the babies when we were at work. But my mum works 6 days a week. My dad works 7 days a week and her dad works 6 days a week.
In Grace, they've got like specials, things like that. So even the parents go sitting with their babies and splash about. There's nothing like that over here. That park's big enough to have so much in, but it's got nothing.
And where you was going to go and film tonight, that leisure park, there's a pub opposite, that's been closed down, and now it's meant to be for blacks, for the church.
Yeah, got a gospel
church. That's going to get blown off straight away from
yeah,
Tilbury.
People will.
I am part of the church. Well, it's like more of the people in Tilbury, but they are recognised and legit and certified to be like a charismatic church. And their impact on society, well, as like the rules of the religion are, that it's a positive impact, as if they're not going to start committing crimes and their only aspect is to make a better way of life. But as they're helping the community, for instance, giving money to charity, doing cooking drives and giving food to the people who need it, that's positive on the community. That's gonna help someone someday. The place I would call the place I'd get away from the world would be, there's this seaside that's, it's not really, it's to me it's a beach, but no one is ever there, just where Tilbury Docks is.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, it's honestly a 20-30 minute walk there, but once you're there, it's just like you're looking at, you don't think about anything else once you're there, apart from when you're alone. I've never really gone there with many people. I've only ever been there with my best friend Dean, and we would sit there for hours and just come back late.
I'm not running up this hill.
Kimchi strider.
This one?
Is that why I've got Ben?
No. Look at Shikani Ella. Elvis Terry. Well, you can...
Knock me down, step my face, surround my mind, blow up from the place. Jack Labour, down.
Cool, alright, yeah.
Days of the Tobits that are the best, stop knife crime.
That's the best.
And that Tilbury Town's sick.
Stop. We're about
to be doing it. So it ain't worth stopping the wars because of terrorists. Hey, that is up.
Why did you leave the bike over there, Todd?
Because we're only stats. On here. So that's knife crime.
Terrorists.
That would be, no, leave that though, that is sick. And that.
Shit.
It is, man on the deck.
I swear your pockets are supposed to be behind, not in front.
Hey?
I swear it's supposed to be behind, not in front.
For his pockets?
Yeah.
Meant to be here, right? Like
the back ones, you know? It's supposed to be behind.
Yeah, I know, but some kids doing it, that's mad, isn't it? Like this one here, can I stop this? Look at the bin on there.
Probably
have. Ewan's on there for where I'm playing with chicken.
He got Nick for standing on his own roof.
But that one, see, I've got that one on Facebook at Tilbury, haven't I?
Mine's better, you should have mine.
I took it inside, but I was standing over there where that Y is. I took it like that.
It's
too long
to get the whole
team turning. That eye. Name's Tony. There's my little mates, Jordan, George, Ben and Jack. 20-year-old. I ain't got a clue how old these are. Lived in Tilbury 5 years. I'm originally from Tilbury, moved away for a few years and come back. But I've been here now about coming up 6 years, something like that. That's about it. But the best thing that's ever happened to me in Tilbury, to be truthful, is having my little girl. Right, that's the only really best thing I've got in Tilbury. Go and meet George, and then we'll take her over to the park, right, let her have a little run around, kick her for football. Right, we'll have her out for a couple of hours over the park, right, go to his house and my house, and right, we'll take her home when she gets tired.
Ben.
Well, George, I got with his sister about 4 months ago, like, we're not together now, but like, when I got with her, like, he started coming out with me, like, he was out with me every day. Like, because where he's got his behaviour problems, when he's out with me, like, he's calm. Like, he keeps himself calm and, like, things like that. What did you used to do? You used to sit indoors all day, didn't you?
Bored.
Yeah, like, bored, so, like, he'd lose his temper and start smashing things up.
So I just joined his primary school, which was Lansdowne.
Yeah.
I had anxiety disorder, and I'd see a psychologist and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. I didn't go to school for a year before that, but that was one of the reasons why I moved. And then I went to his primary school, and it was all good. He's like a friendship, actually. He's like one of the things that's made me cope with things more than anything. But
well, in all honesty. When you were younger, I enjoyed spending so much time with him that I needed him to be at my school, if you know what I mean.
He's in the flats just over there, actually. I can't remember what flat it was, but it was when my dad was alive. And I remember going to his door and with my mum, just my mum, I had a chest infection at the time. And there was all blood splattered over his door. And it's because some kids, there was only about 18, but there was about nine of them. And my cousin, my own cousin, and they went in there just to steal some DVDs or something. They went and beat my dad up and that done something to him. They must have done something to him at his door, because I remember there was blood just spattered up against the door, and I told my mum, "What's that?" And she said it was something else. I can't remember. She said it was just paint or something like that. But that memory is stuck in my head, even though I must have been 4 at most, because my dad died before I was 5. And it's stuck in my head, and I think to myself, how can kids do that?
On a normal day in Tilbury, I'd be getting drunk, stoned and acting up. Natural Tilbury thing. Can't get a bit of work. All the foreigners, cheap labour, give them a tenner, they'll work for a year. Mm. Can't get no jobs around here. Especially yeah. You got a record, that's it, you ain't getting nothing. Well, can't say no, the best has happened in Tilbury.
Many?
Yeah, my little boy. That's the only best thing that's happened to me in Tilbury, my little boy. And meeting friends since I've been here.
When I was at my old house, I used to do really bad things. I used to go out, it's called terrorising, and used to just throw stones at people's windows. And now thinking back, I think, oh, what an idiot. I was only 9 at the time, but still. And I used to be one of the people, one of the kids that swears all the time, and literally only 6 years old and swearing. But as soon as I met him, he started to change me. And it's only now, it's only in the past couple of years that I've actually wanted to do something. I wanted to get out of here and do something. It might be selfish to say or something like that, but I want to be remembered, not just be this little town boy who's...
And you grew up,
lived in life, had no goals, just stayed in his house and not be. Yeah. I want to be remembered.
It's like,
I want
it's
to.
It's like saying, all the lights among here can be seen and known, but the only light remembered is the moon.
From the time I was 13 till now, I don't really think Tilbury's changed much. It's still the same. It's the same people. Everyone's just got older. Same things happen. I wouldn't say Tilbury's a bad place.
I say we could get better.
It could be better. but whatever you do, if we were standing over here looking at this, then the police would probably question us on what you're doing over here. No matter what, you're always
in trouble.
Yeah, you're always in trouble. You can't do nothing without being in trouble.
No.
Come here, Ben.
I should talk something there.
We'll have a kick about. A few games of football. Be careful. We'll have a few games of football. Someone will bring over some boxing gloves. We'll have a little spa. Give each other a good little beating, and then I take a couple of little ones to have a little one, take the dogs out to have a run, put the ferrets on rabbits and all things like that. Every time you go to look for a job, you go in the dock. They won't give you a job in the dock because they're paying the immigrants more money, less money to do the work. So they'd rather pay them less money than give an English person minimum wage. So if they're getting it cheaper, they're going to employ the cheaper people. It's hard to find work.
I'll knock you out,
bruv.
You alright with your breath?
We were in Jack's, weren't we? We walked downtown and there's groups of people. What's going on? And you had white swans who had
black's the outside.
Outside the youth centre, as we've come back in the taxi, they're planning to go up there and just run right. They were planning a big riot thing. And there was about 50 police officers.
If not more.
There.